Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and welcome to the Winston School's 93rd commencement, and perhaps more importantly, its first truly global graduation. This celebration is happening around the world today, and given all that you have accomplished, Class of 2020, it is worthy of that very scope. Welcome, parents. Welcome to our families, friends, and trustees. To our underclass students, and a very special welcome to our faculty and staff. Normally, there'd be a big round of applause right there. This day belongs to all these people too, as they have played a big role in getting you and us here today. And now, a special hello to you, the Winston School Class of 2020, the stars of the day, the talented, smart, athletic, musical, resilient, empathetic, courageous, and often funny members of Winchendon's Class of 2020. Through much of the spring, I was feeling very badly that your time at Winchendon would culminate in a virtual event like this. And I do, a bit. But I also believe that we should be celebrating as a Class of 2020 as a globally shared experience that will be instilled in our memories forever. The massive disruptive events such as World War I and World War II and the Great Depression were part of your great and great-great-grandparents' experience, the stories that they carried with them forever, and hopefully you had the chance to hear some of them. Your graduation today, this idea of a virtually globally connected celebration, a celebration that is being experienced by the majority of high school and university seniors around the world, and by the Winchendon family, sure, distance in many states in at least 12 or 15 countries and who knows how many time zones if we look at things physically, but united in spirit and heart as Winchwapedi, is groundbreaking. It's epic and will prove to be revolutionary in a new era of education that you are the pioneers of. This, your senior year, will be a memorable year for many decades. And while no one could have anticipated the turmoil, through this and so much else that you have accomplished, you have already demonstrated the adaptability and fortitude to be successful and positive through such dramatic disruption. So, we could be sad not to be sitting on a potentially damp and buggy hillside in Massachusetts, or we can celebrate your accomplishments and pioneering attitudes. We can celebrate it how connected we are in our spirit and in our hearts. And we can celebrate you as a class that will have the legacy of being the first at Winchendon to have a truly global commencement. I am so proud of you. We are so proud of you. I'm going to kick things off by introducing beloved teacher and faculty member extraordinaire Ramona Reed to provide for the invocation and blessing.
Would you bow your heads with me, please, for the invocation? Father, I thank you for the proceedings today and for all the hard work, accomplishments, and individual growth that they represent. I thank you for the dedication of our faculty and staff and for the promise of our graduates. I ask that the lessons that they have learned here, the skills that they have gained here, and the friendships that they made here will remain with them and gird them throughout their future. Bless them, I pray, with a sense of purpose and gratitude as they leave this place. Amen.
Thank you, Mr. Kearney and Ms. Reed. Welcome all, especially our seniors and postgraduates. Thank you to all the parents and families who are watching us today. We are so proud of the class of 2020, and each one of you has grown tremendously in the time that you have been at the Winchendon School, whether for 1 year or four. You only need to look at those photos from freshman year with our lifer students to see the physical difference. But there are many other elements that I have seen occur as well. The willingness to connect with others, to help the community, to be a leader, to take a risk, to stand out from the crowd, and to expand on a passion, whether in athletics, the arts, clubs, service learning, and/or collab. I have seen students gain in confidence intellectually academically and socially. And I have seen real character develop and expand so that the Wapitis who head out into the world today are truly thoughtful, empathetic, courageous, and responsible. Think about how much more adaptable we are as a result of our winch experience and the way that we have tackled this very difficult spring. Yes, it has been an unusual year, but we have supported each other and we have persevered. Students, you have taken advantage of many great opportunities. You have proven your resilience and grit and talent, and you are really ready to move on and to commence with whatever comes next. Perhaps that is the key to this ceremony today. Graduation is a way of celebrating the achievements of the past, but commencement is a way to recognize the start of a new chapter. You are well prepared to move on to whatever lies ahead and have great and purposeful lives. Before we start forward, though, let us recognize those important contributions to the school and to your class. A major factor in making this year so special was our hardworking, upbeat, and energetic student body presidents.
Good morning, Winchendon. It is hard to believe that my time at the Winchendon School has come to an end. Each year has come with new adventures, new people, and new lessons. I would like to say a few words to the people who have impacted me the most. To the faculty, thank you for putting your all into teaching us and caring for us each and every day. When I was in the first grade, my teacher got really mad at us one day and said, "I am not your friend, I am your teacher." Although I was only 7 years old at the time, I never forgot what she said that day. That statement puzzled me my whole life because in my head, a teacher shouldn't just be your teacher. You spend more time with them than you do your own family. A teacher should be someone you trust. Someone you aren't afraid to go to if you need help, whether it be with homework or something personal. When I came to Winch, I finally met teachers that aren't just there to teach you, but who are there to be your friend as well. Teachers who actually care about you and love you, and it shows in everything they do. So, thank you for being the best friends and teachers we could ever ask for. To the underclassmen, I said this to you in the beginning of the year, and I will say it again. In everything you do, no matter if it is in the classroom, on the field, on the ice, or on the court, always remember that you are your own competition. You're competing with yourself, not with your classmate or a teammate. Your goal should always be to perform better than your last performance, not better than your peers. To the class of 2020, we have waited 4 years, some of us five, for our moment. The moment for us to walk across the stage and receive our diploma. Unfortunately, due to circumstances completely out of our control, that moment was taken from all of us when we least expected it. Although we cannot be physically with each other, let's not let that take away from all of you and your accomplishments. Each of you have worked so hard to get to this point. All the sleepless nights and hard decisions have led up to this point, and I am so proud of each and every one of you. To my best friends, thank you for remaining true these past 4 years. I wouldn't be the person I am today if I hadn't met you three. And although it breaks my heart that we won't be together next year, I know you ladies will do amazing things and bring light into more people's lives at your new schools. I love you guys so much. Finally, I would like to say thank you to my family. Thank you for pushing me to be the best I can be. No matter what I choose to do, you guys have always supported me and have never clipped my wings. I came to the Winchendon School thanks to you. Next year, I will attend Colby, the college of my dreams, thanks to you. Being a woman, and on top of that, a Hispanic woman, society places me into categories that deem me unworthy of success and prosperity. Regardless of societal norms, I promise I will continue to make my family proud and break the cycle, one diploma at a time. I love you with all my heart. Ahora lo voy a decir en español para mis abuelitos, papi y mami. Gracias por empujarme a ser la mejor versión de mí que yo pueda ser. Sin importar lo que haya elegido hacer, ustedes siempre me han apoyado y nunca me han cortado las alas. Si vine a esta escuela, fue gracias a ustedes. El año que viene, asistiré a Colby, la universidad de mis sueños, gracias a ustedes. Todo lo que hago es para hacerlos orgullosos de mí. Ser mujer, y encima de eso, una mujer hispana, me coloca en categorías que me consideran indigna del éxito y la prosperidad. Independientemente de las normas sociales, continuaré haciéndolos sentir orgullosos y romper el ciclo, un diploma a la vez. Los amo con todo el corazón. Papi Víctor, gracias por siempre estar dispuesto a llevarme a la escuela. Sé que lo haces de corazón y disfrutas hacerlo. Eres una pieza clave de mi éxito en esta escuela. Well, this is really the end. I am so lucky to have spent the last 4 years with the most amazing people ever. I love you all so much and will forever hold you and this school near and dear to my heart.
Good morning, Winchendon. That will be the last time we will be saying that as your co-presidents. Congratulations, you all have made it despite everything that has been going on. Graduates, the time is here. We are not high school students anymore, but are now a part of something even bigger. As they say, underneath something great lies a solid foundation. And as your co-presidents, Haley and I are more than honored to have the opportunity to be up here and speak for the class of 2020. Unlike Haley, my high school experience was in two countries. My freshman and sophomore years were back in Vietnam. Junior year was when I first arrived at Winchendon in the United States. As an international student, having to adapt to a new culture or using a second language on a daily basis were not easy. Looking back at when I was moving into Jaffe on the first day, everyone was playing dorm golf, good times, squeezing my way through the hallway, thinking to myself, please do not say hi to me. Don't say hi to me. My room is just right down the hallway. And someone said, hey, is that all the stuff you're bringing with you? It was the longest 5 seconds of my life. She was someone I've never met before, from a different culture, and it was a she too. So I was a bit nervous. I thought to myself, yeah, I'm out. I'm not saying hi back. I walked straight to my room and was glad I made it. I was scared. This was who I am, who I was comfortable being. Back then, I never had the thought of pushing myself out of my comfort zone. I never thought about changing it up. You might think to yourself, how is that guy the co-president of the whole student body? You are not alone. I ask myself the same question. Well, who changed me? This community, the Winchendon family. Lunar New Year was when I first gave a speech in front of so many people. To this day, I can never thank Mr. Englehart and Ms. Kang enough for giving me the opportunity to go up in front of everyone to express my feelings in such short notice. After that speech, D'Lo came up to me and said that he learned so much about my culture and the importance of the things I celebrate. That simple moment welcomed me to the family, and not only did it change what I thought about everyone, but it also opened up a new side of me, a more confident and a more active individual. Taking that initiative, I applied to be a service learning leader, applied to become a proctor, even acted and sang in Mamma Mia. I pushed myself to join events and do things that would get me new friends and to learn more about the people around me. And last but not least, I decided to run for president after 8 months at the Witch. Crazy, isn't it? Would I have never done all the things that I did if I did not get the chance to? Probably, but I was given many opportunities and I utilized it. Even though it's virtually, overcoming the fear that 50 or 100 people or even more will be listening to me is absolutely terrifying. I wouldn't be here without the help and the encouragement and the support from the staff and faculty here at Witch. Conference might be a time for someone to talk about a grade or an assignment, but sometimes I just needed someone to tell me, hey Andy, you are doing fine. I am here if you need me. There'll be a retake next week. Thank you, teachers. Not only for being here amid the pandemic, but being here for all of us and for me. To my friends, Thank you for always believing in me and supporting me on my journey. Your advice might not always work or what I chose not to listen to, but I knew you guys were always there for me. I will be missing the runs to the dining hall from the gym in shorts during winter, or the trips down to McDonald's every weekend, or as simply as the constant yelling to nicely ask the kids on my floor to take the trash out. Without all of your influence, I would have never been able to be the person I desired to be. By the way, Christopher Blake Morey, happy 18th birthday, man. Last but not least, to my family. Having to move over on my own and not getting the chance to be with my family through Christmas or New Year's Eve, it was pretty tough. I missed them a lot. Mom, Dad, and Euro, thank you for trusting me and sending me over here on my own. Even though I knew you sent me over as a guinea pig for Euro, but anyways, I would never trust myself, but you guys did. And you trusted me, and it gave me a chance to seek discomfort and change myself. I am proud that Euro is also on the same track as I was. You can do it, Euro. My fellow graduates, we might not have the chance to end the year like we were supposed to. We might not have gotten a prom. We might not have the chance to walk across the stage and look down into the audience looking for your parents' cameras like we dreamt about. We might not get the chance to throw our graduation hats with our classmates like we wanted to, but we had the chance to spend our last year with people whom I proudly called my second family.
To all, thank you for an amazing school year. Although it was cut short, the memories we made in the few months we had together will live on forever in our hearts.
Thank you, class of 2020.
We out.
Haley and Andy, you both represented your class so well this year, and your words of wisdom remind us of the strength of your class and the bright promise of your future. Thank you. While today is principally about the great class of 2020, we do want to acknowledge a few other members of this community who have supported the class of 2020 and so many others in all of their achievements.
Before we turn our attention to the graduates, I want to start by acknowledging a group who may have accomplished even more today. I often think that on a day like this, that there should be two sets of diplomas, one for the students and one for the parents. Graduates, as you revel in and celebrate your own accomplishments, I hope that you will pause to make sure that you thank your parents for everything that went into getting you here today. They have put up with a lot and have made many sacrifices to provide you with this opportunity. And each year, before we get to the student awards and diplomas, we pause to celebrate a couple of adults in our community who have made a real difference. We do that by awarding these chairs that you see around campus like this, and these recipients will each receive. Today, we celebrate two such people. First up is the Rotenberg Chair, in honor of longtime supporter of the school, Faye Rotenberg, who was the mother of John Rotenberg. The gym is named for Mrs. Rotenberg, and our fine arts building is named for Mr. Rotenberg. Mrs. Rotenberg was a very loyal parent who helped the school greatly, not only financially, but also with great moral support and encouragement, especially in challenging times. Each year, the Faye Rotenberg Chair is presented to a member of the community who's made a significant contribution to the life of the school. This year, the Rotenberg Chair goes to a member of our community who's been like a fairy godparent to a series of our students, without most of them ever knowing it. He supports the school in many ways, almost always anonymously, but he also gets most excited to support students who need a financial boost to make being at Winchendon possible. Over the last decade, the recipient and his wife, Janet, have sponsored numerous students, including a couple in this year's class of 2020. It is with so much appreciation and pleasure that we present the 2020 Rotenberg Chair to Jim Hutel, member of the class of 1971, an incredible friend to this community and to me. Thanks, Jim. The second award is the John J. Newberry Award, given in honor of the longtime president of our Board of Trustees. With it, we recognize the adult member of our community who shows exceptional loyalty and devotion to the school. Exceptional loyalty and devotion. If you are on campus you've heard this year's recipient whistling, or practicing on the piano, or sharing his special Canadian sense of humor. He was the original catalyst for the girls' hockey team, hounding me before I even took the job at Winchendon. He is taught all over in the curriculum, is the epitome of a lifelong learner, is one of the most adaptive and curious in technology, despite the fact that he may have grown up with an abacus. We really put up with him because with him, we also get Chantel and Rosie. But in all seriousness, in good times and in bad, through challenges and disruption, Jacques Delorme is as steady as it gets when it comes to exceptional loyalty and devotion to the Winchendon School. It is with great appreciation, pleasure, and respect that I award the 2020 John J. Newbery Award to Jacques Delorme. And now we will hear from Dan Christian.
Thank you, class of 2020, for selecting me to give the faculty farewell. I did hear through the grapevine that it was a close vote that included Miss Stacy and Mr. Delorme, but no one understands him. And as luck would have it, Miss Stacy was out because last year's graduation, she messed up PhD Friedman. Anywho, for those faculty members who fell short, Jeff Truax told me what put me over the top was the awesome way I come up with questions for the mathonomics tests. His favorite one was about pensions that went, Tommy used to work on the docks. Union's been on strike. He's down on his luck. It's tough, so tough. But he's luckily been employed for 20 years, earning a pension at 1.7% on the average of his last 4 years' salaries. Calculate Tommy's pension. It was after I wrote that question, I realized there's so much wisdom in 80s music. I actually learned about resilience from a song when I was in high school. The melody escapes me right now, but the words were, you wake up late for school, man, you don't want to go. You ask your mom, please, but she still says no. You miss two classes and no homework, but your teacher preaches class like you're some kind of jerk. You gotta fight for your right to party. I also learned about resourcefulness from a song. Again, I can't remember how the music goes, but Tommy Two Tone said, Jenny, I got your number. I need to make you mine. Jenny, don't change your number. 867. Well, you know what? That doesn't make sense. You guys have smartphones, so you don't need to remember numbers. In fact, you're way better at using smartphones than old people, and you're way more resourceful. I'm gonna go with my backup plan then, which was to read you a couple of letters that I got from people who knew I was gonna be speaking today. This one came from Florida. Hey, all you cool cats and kittens. Congratulations on scratching and clawing your way to the end of the year. And what a crazy year. But look at the bright side. At least you don't have a Netflix documentary wrecking your life. Anyway, if you need it's summer internships, we got plenty of spots down here. Best wishes, Carol. Thanks, Carol. Here's another. Dear Winchendon class of 2020, you are a fabulous class. Believe me, you guys are going to be huge. You're very special, very beautiful, really terrific. Those other classes, total disasters. Ask anyone. Everyone agrees, trust me. All the best, Donald. So you guys must have made a strong impression. I also received some notes from faculty to say. Mr. Delorme says, bonne chance, pour la suite. See what I mean? Mr. Thiesing said, what a class. They lasted at Winch way longer than I did. That's true. Mr. Troy says, I'm gonna miss you, class of 20. In this last quarter, you've been the quietest dorm I've ever had. Miss Stacy says, I can't believe they asked you to give the farewell. Okay, so you know what? Let's just wrap this up. I'd just like to say that we seriously have so much respect for you all. Your strength and willingness to embrace the positives in this experience, or simply just accept that this global pandemic is our reality, while we tried to continue to deliver the Winchendon experience, it's been amazing to witness. And we're so proud to have had a role in helping you close out your high school journey. It's really because of you that many of us have been able to come to grips with our current situation and figure out a way to make this work. So congratulations, and we can't wait to see what you conquer next. Thank you, and God bless you.
Now it is time to begin to celebrate the accomplishments of the members of the class of 2020. each year, we recognize those students who have gained distinction in their work here at the Winchendon School, whether cum laude or summa cum laude. In doing so, we wish to encourage those who follow to strive for the kind of dedication and the sense of purpose that we honor today. As I list the names, I will also add if the students are members of the National Honor Society. It is the school's second year as a National Honor Society chapter. As a part of NHS, we celebrate our shared values of scholarship, service, character, and leadership. Before we begin the presentation of named student awards, I would like to recognize these two separate groups of students. First, students earning a grade point average of higher than 3.0 out of a possible 4.0 for at least the last two academic years at Winchendon are awarded the status of cum laude. Niklas Arapelto, Jaden Beliveau-Ryan, Tristan Berg, Luke Black, Daryl Brooks, Lynette Cardoso, Daniel Cavanaugh, National Honor Society, Kai Chen, Zikai Du, Hongyuan Fan, National Honor Society, Yujie Guo, Tristan Heap, Regan Honeywell, Tingchen Li, Elizabeth Loganoff, National Honor Society, Yiding Ma, National Honor Society, Christopher Mori, Tate Nyamala, Elizabeth Jiao Scott, Griffin Tomashiki, National Honor Society, Michaela Walsh, National Honor Society, Tyoshi Watanabe, Harold Watton, National Honor Society, Yumin Wu, Zhenbang Shu, Zijun Zhu. Congratulations to each of you on doing such a great job. And for earning a GPA higher than 3.7 out of 4.0 for at least the last two academic years at Winchendon, the following students are graduating summa cum laude. Jackson Bright, National Honor Society. Cassandra Burdick, National Honor Society. Maxim Cowett, National Honor Society. Haley Guzman German, National Honor Society Parliamentarian. Julia Holmes, National Honor Society. Fu An Hong, National Honor Society. Emma Landry, National Honor Society President. Nancy Lin. Caitlin Marchant, National Honor Society Vice President. Kylie McCumber, National Honor Society Secretary. Tegan McGuire, National Honor Society. Javier Morajon Hernandez. Nathan Nickerson, National Honor Society. Bianca Ortiz, National Honor Society Treasurer. Natalie Parker, National Honor Society, and Connor Wilkie, National Honor Society. And there are two postgraduates to recognize as a part of the National Honor Society as they were members at their previous schools, Corey Bright and Patrick Casserly. What exceptional accomplishments for all. Congratulations.
Throughout his career in education, longtime head Robert Marr always recognized excellence in others and demanded excellence for himself. Mr. Marr ran the school from 1961 through 1973, and our first classroom building recognizes his leadership. It is in his name that we honor excellence in each of our academic disciplines. These awards are made possible through the generosity of one of Mr. Marr's former students, George Elkins, class of 1964. I am going to read off the names of all Marr Award winners. Award winners, please send us a photo of you with your box once you receive it in the mail. for excellence in the study of global dynamics, Kylie McCumber. For excellence in the study of mathematics, Jackson Bright. For excellence in the study of foreign language, Fuan Andy Hong. For excellence in the study of science, Yujia Peter Guo. For excellence in the study of fine arts, Tristan Heap. For excellence in the study of performing arts, Tegan McGuire. Congratulations to all of you. This year's recipient of the Ryan Harris Perseverance Award is a young man who has learned to work through many obstacles, all while being a great ambassador for the school. Thinking back to the fall of 2016, when I first met this young man, he has come a long way in terms of being a hardworking member of our community. That year, we spent many service learning classes talking about avenues to eliminate food insecurity. Just before or at lunchtime. Not always an easy conversation. From the beginning, he has been focused on academics, athletics, and the community, which is evident in his honor roll status that was mentioned earlier in the ceremony, as well as the award he received during the Winter Awards Banquet. A four-year member of the basketball program, he always gave his best effort in the pursuit of his dreams. The 2020 Ryan Harris Perseverance Award goes to Tristan Berg. This award is presented in memory of Mr. John Frazee, our former friend and colleague. Mr. Frazee was a committed and highly disciplined lifelong student, always seeking to understand the latest technology and methodologies in the rapidly evolving field. His thirst for new knowledge was remarkable, and more often than not, he had to teach himself, as there was no teacher for him. In recognition of his commitment to learning, we created the John Frazee Award for Technology and Learning to be awarded to a student each year to celebrate their accomplishments in the field that John loved so much. It is a special pleasure today to give this award to Joe Kulikowski. This award is given by the faculty to a senior that has demonstrated continuous progress and diligence in their study of the English language. I'm very happy to present the English Proficiency Award for 2020 to Hong Yuan Fred Fan.
The Stephen V.A. Samborski Scholar Athlete Award is given to the student who has best combined academic excellence and outstanding athletic achievement. Mr. Samborski was a dedicated scholar athlete at Harvard. In his years as headmaster at Winchendon, he taught the honors senior English class and coached the varsity hockey team. His love of intellectual and athletic endeavors is recognized in these awards. The awardees, in the opinion of the faculty, have demonstrated enthusiasm, excellence, and commitment in their athletic activities while demonstrating competence and consistent diligence in their studies. While competence and academic performance is our primary goal, athletics too are important to us. We like to win, but more importantly, we like to be sportsmanlike, and we like to be gracious in victory and defeat. The awardees this year have represented us well. The 2020 Male Samborski Award winner is Danny Cavanaugh. The 2020 Female Samborski Award winner is Bianca Ortiz.
The Board of Trustees wishes to honor the memory of Barry Jaffe, our treasurer for over 30 years, by making an award each year to an outstanding community servant. Service learning here at Winchendon is truly in the spirit of Barry Jaffe and his longtime friend, Gene Perkins, who both gave so much to this and many other communities for so many years. In some schools, community service is a token activity accomplished by a bit of work on the campus. Our students truly give needed service on campus to the Winchendon community locally and to our broader global community. Barry Jaffe would commend their spirit of giving, as do we. Congratulations, Cassandra Burdick. The Jose Gregory Alonso II Award is given in memory of Pepe Alonso, a member of the class of 1973. In his years at Winchendon, Pepe consistently demonstrated leadership, school spirit, warmth, and a cheerful manner. He was a loyal friend who encouraged and assisted the discouraged to make another try. The senior recognized each year, in the opinion of the faculty, best captures the positiveness, helpfulness, loyalty, and good spirit of Pepe Alonso. On behalf of the faculty, I am pleased to present the 2020 Pepe Alonso Award to Cassandra Burdick. The following award is both important and more lighthearted: the Mountain Day Award for Selflessness, Leadership, and Perseverance. As I think back on our Mountain Day last fall, it was an amazing day, in great part because of how many people worked together to make sure that all had fun and made it up the mountain. Our Mountain Award winner helped other students make it up the mountain and never gave up. He was a great example of character and selflessness. Congratulations to Dara O'Sullivan.
The Dean Leo R. O'Neill Award is given to an international student who possesses the qualities Dean O'Neill showed for so many years, an enthusiasm for and diligence in one's work, purposefulness in achieving one's goals, and honesty and fairness in one's relationships with others. In addition to recognizing his purposefulness and academic success, the faculty, in making this award, wish to recognize a young person of exceptionally high character who has been a great friend to many. The 2020 O'Neill Award winner is Fuan Andy Hong. John A. Kearney Innovator Award is given to honor the spirit of innovation and entrepreneurship that is an integral and important component of our former head of school and current CEO, John Kearney. A former businessman who is not afraid to take a risk to benefit the students and the school community, John Kearney continues to lead the Winchendon School, whether here or in Brooklyn, in enterprising, courageous, and thoughtful ways. His enthusiasm for innovative education and his love for hands-on learning have propelled the school forward, and his impact on this school has been significant, undeniably positive, and transformative. This award is given to a student who reflects the characteristics listed above and captures the innovative spirit embodied by John Kearney. Kylie has been recognized publicly for her work with her nonprofit organization, Kylie's Care Kits for Kids. As a result of that work, she was interviewed on Channel 5 as a part of their A+ student series and earned state and then national recognition as the Massachusetts honoree of the Prudential Spirit of Community Awards program. In addition, her story was picked up by People magazine and was highlighted on the recent CNN special, Class of 2020, In This Together. On behalf of the faculty, I am pleased to present the John A. Kearney Innovator Award to Kylie McCumber. And now for the Vestigia dedication. We proudly dedicate the 2019-2020 edition of the yearbook to an amazing teacher and mentor. Words used to describe this individual include selfless, unrelenting, compassionate, kind, empathetic, optimistic, hardworking, resilient, and dedicated to pushing students outside of their comfort zones. Her youngest daughter says that she is the best mom because she helps people when they are hurt, and when people are sad, she helps them get happy. Her son says that she is my best friend, and I love her. None of us know how she does all that she does. These sentiments are shared by many. As one of her students says, it is remarkable how many tasks she juggles in one day. I don't know anyone else who can facilitate 19 service learning groups, be an amazing Spanish teacher, and an even more wonderful mother of three. She is definitely someone I look up to. As another student has commented, Mrs. Jennings is dedicated to making the world a better place and an environment for everyone. Congratulations, Mrs. Jennings, on receiving the dedication of the Vestigia this year. You have had a huge and powerful impact on the class of 2020 and on the school as a whole. And now to introduce our valedictorian. This award is given in honor of longtime headmaster Louis Posich and his wife Violet. Given her remarkable achievement, it is not surprising that our valedictorian has already picked up another award. She is a summa cum laude and high honor roll student, a service learning leader for the Theater for Change group, a talented artist who was a regular in Art Portfolio and demonstrated her skill in a Painting with the Masters collab, a wonderful performer in multiple musicals and play productions, including this spring's virtual show, As You Like It, and this winter's Putnam County Spelling Bee collab, a regular in vocal performance class, a varsity tennis player, and a member of the National Honor Society. It is with great pleasure that I give the Posich Award to the senior with the highest GPA, a perfect 4.0, to this year's valedictorian of the Winchendon School Class of 2020, Tegan McGuire.
Good morning to my fellow graduates, to all of the faculty and staff, and to all of the parents and families watching today's ceremony. This has undoubtedly been uncharted territory for all, so I would like to start this speech by thanking everyone who has supported our class throughout this very uncertain time, and everyone who has strived to make the end of this year as special as possible for all of us. I, and I'm sure my classmates would agree, would like to thank all of the parents and families who have supported us in our academic endeavors throughout high school, but also during these past few months when it has undoubtedly mattered the most. We would not be where we are today without you. I would also like to thank all of the faculty and staff for continuing to provide us with an education and a support system throughout this difficult time, and for helping to organize all of this. Lastly, I would like to thank my fellow classmates for continuing to persevere and stay strong for these past few months despite all of the new challenges presented. I know it's cliche, but we're all in this together. If you had told me 4 years ago that I would have to speak at my graduation in front of the entire school and everyone's families, I probably would have spontaneously combusted from the stress of even thinking about public speaking. Thankfully, that didn't happen, and I'm standing here, though not in person, and delivering a speech. That's what I call character development. So upon learning that I would, in fact, have to make a speech, instead of bursting into flames, I started thinking about what I actually wanted to say, which presented almost a larger challenge because I had absolutely no idea what to say. And then I thought about where we all are now versus where we were at the start of our high school careers. And I realized that we have all grown a lot and have accomplished things that seemed nearly impossible at one point. And for me personally, I believe that the biggest reason that I have been able to flourish, not only as a student, but as a person, is because I was encouraged to try. And I think that's something that could be said for all of us. During our time here, we were all encouraged to try new things and to make mistakes that we could learn from. When I got here as a freshman, I was a bit of a nervous wreck, to put it lightly. And I know that must come as a surprise to many of you, but it's true. In all seriousness though, I have learned that it's okay to try new things and to meet new people. And I realized that things did not always have to go perfectly for them to be meaningful or impactful. It was a hard lesson to learn. It required going way out of my comfort zone and persevering despite my worries. But if I hadn't branched out and tried new things, I never would have had nearly as many opportunities as I did. As I started to navigate and explore these opportunities, I gained more confidence in myself. And without that confidence, I never would have become a service learning leader and discovered the joys of making a weekly teaching schedule. I would have never painted an enormous painting in a medium I had never used before. I never would have sung a solo without bursting into tears, and I never would have given this speech. And while I know that these examples of personal growth are very specific to me, I know that we have all had similar experiences during our time here, whether that be 4 years or just one. It seems very fitting that our theme for this year has been resilience, and I'm sure it has been mentioned before, but I think we have undoubtedly demonstrated our resilience time and time again throughout this year. And we have grown into the people we are today because of our experiences. It has definitely not been easy, to say the least. We have done so much and accomplished so much that it would have been such a shame for it all to go unnoticed. We've all brought something unique to this community, and it wouldn't be the same otherwise. To wrap the speech up, I would like to read part of a quote by Eleanor Roosevelt that I think pretty much sums up my speech in much more eloquent and concise terms. You gain strength, courage, and confidence by every experience in which you really stop to look fear in the face. You must do the thing you think you cannot do. So, with that, to everyone in my graduating class, congratulations, we finally did it. And I know that we'll be able to move on and do great things if we just continue to try. Thank you.
Thank you, Tegan, and congratulations on your remarkable accomplishments. The next award is the Lloyd Harvey Hatch Award in honor of our founder. In the mid-1920s, Mr. Hatch had a vision of creating a different kind of school committed to educating each student as an individual through close engagement with teachers and an innovative approach. That vision continues to guide everything we do at Winchendon 93 years later. The Latin motto that accompanies the school crest is Vestigia nulla retrorsum, which means no steps backward. Our goal is to take students from where they are when they arrive to some place significantly better. It is my feeling that the mark of any good school lies primarily in the improvement shown by its students. The Hatch Award is voted on by the faculty and awarded to that student who has shown significant improvement in his or her time with us. This year, the Hatch Award is being given to a kind, caring, thoughtful student who has consistently stepped outside of her comfort zone here at Winchendon. Her teachers would say that she works tirelessly in the pursuit of her academic goals, which has led her to have great success in the classroom. Her dedication to service learning has not wavered, even in this virtual learning period. Her group has found ways to keep connected to veterans, frontline workers, and others facing COVID-19 on a daily basis. If you look closely in the yearbook, her parents have given her another last name, Pasternak, which just goes to show her love of the Bruins. This year, the Lloyd Harvey Hatch Award is given to Caitlin Mary Marchand. The Head of School Award is given to that member of the senior class who, by his or her exemplary character, quiet endeavor, and commitment to the school, exemplifies our purpose. With this award, we recognize what we hope to see most in our students: honesty, a sense of values, and a willingness to give of oneself to the community. This student exemplifies those ideals by being a service learning leader, a proctor, a varsity athlete in volleyball, a performer in numerous plays and musicals, a summa cum laude and high honor roll student, and the parliamentarian of the National Honor Society. It is with much appreciation and respect that I present the 2020 Head of School Award to Haley German Guzman. And now, we are getting close to that part of the ceremony that we have all been waiting for. However, without a board of trustees and the ceaseless hours that they invest, none of this Winchendon experience, the multitudes of opportunities, innovative programs like collabs or service learning, or our very campus exists. Most of you have seen Glenn around campus at least once a week during the regular time, if not more, and he is always here for your shows, symposia, or games. He cares so much for all of us. I would like to ask the president of our Board of Trustees, Mr. Glenn Hunt, to share a few thoughts. Glenn.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, welcome to the 93rd graduation of the Winchendon School, and a very special one it is. This will be the first time in history that many graduating classes all over the country and all over the world will be holding virtual graduations. I'm thankful for that. In today's world, we have the technology that enables us to do so. I'm thankful for a few other things also. I'm thankful and grateful for our parents for choosing a Winchendon education for your sons and daughters. Thank you for sticking with us and helping us through the spring semester as we pivoted quickly to provide a robust, meaningful, virtual learning experience to our students. I'm thankful for our CEO, John Kearney, Head of School Winchendon, Laurie Lambert, and Head of School Brooklyn, Sean Duncan, for anticipating the shelter-in-place orders and being way ahead of the curve, planning ways to keep our schools not only running, but still being able to deliver our curriculum effectively to our students via virtual classrooms. I'm thankful for our dedicated faculty that executed the plan and made it happen. This was no easy task with many obstacles that you had to overcome, but you did it. The best in every one of you came to the forefront. Your dedication to our students and making sure they were not going to be left behind is palpable. I'm thankful for our administration, facilities, maintenance, housekeeping, and dining staffs for doing whatever it takes during this difficult time. Your work is truly appreciated. I'm thankful for our Board of Trustees, many of whom are alums, for your hard work and dedication, and for your unwavering support of the school and its mission. But most of all, I'm extremely thankful for our class of 2020. This class is a shining example of students who will go on to change our world. It is readily apparent that our grade 8 core values are ingrained in every one of you. All of you showed us how adaptable, collaborative, resilient, responsible, resourceful, empathetic, ethical, and most of all, how courageous you are. You pushed us and yourselves to make sure this new virtual learning experience would work. Be proud of what you have accomplished this year under extremely difficult circumstances. Normally, I would get the opportunity to hand you a diploma, shake your hand, and congratulate you on a job well done. I truly hope that somehow during the year, we will get the opportunity to meet again so I can get that handshake in person with our future leaders. Until then, congratulations, good health, and may all the best come to each and every one of you. You have certainly earned it and you deserve it. Thank you.
We are now ready to move on to the diplomas. Normally, Mr. Kearney and Mr. Lambert would come up to help me. Mr. Lambert and his team of Mrs. Christian and Mrs. Harrington have done a fabulous job of counseling this class through the college application and selection process, even with the added stress of this spring. I also want to say a very special thank you to so many who make a day like this come together. The buildings and grounds team, our SAGE team normally, Ms. Byrne and our talented vocalists, all of our speakers today, our tech team of Mr. Cormier and Mr. Jetty, Mr. Holby for his filming, and one amazing group of teachers and staff. Thank you all very much for making this such a special occasion, a celebration for our seniors and postgraduates and their families. I also want to offer a very special thank you to the remarkable Winchendon School faculty in particular. We wouldn't be here today without the wonderful opportunities that you have provided this class, the encouragement, the many joyful moments, the love, the humor, sometimes the tough love, and so much else that you have given to this great group of students. And now to the main event. Mr. Hunt and Mr. Kearney, I present to you the Winchendon School Class of 2020. They have satisfied all requirements for graduation and are qualified to receive their diplomas. Graduates. Catherine Grace Adenolfi. Robert Thomas Alcock. Ator Amaral. Nicholas Alexei Arapelto. Jaden Philip Bellevaux Ryan. Tristan Ryan Berg. Luke Herget Black. Madison Brayshaw. Corey James Bright. Jackson Jeffrey Bright. Daryl Lamont Brooks II. Max Hunter Brown. Kevin Thomas Buckley. Cassandra Dawn Burdick. David Christopher Burke. Maxim Andre Coet. Lynette Cardoso. Patrick Francis Casserly. Daniel Harty Kavanaugh. Jingwen Chen. Kai Chen. Zikai Du. Hongyuan Fan. Andrew Robert Fitzhenry. Andrew Lewis Glass. Long Chao Guo. Yujia Guo. Haley Giselle Guzman German. Dexter Jermaine Hamilton. Ethan Michael Hamilton. Tristan Heap. Julia Michelle Holmes. Fu An Hong. Regan Joy Honeywell. Lishan Jiang. Alexandra Lee Johnson. Liam Patrick Kilgallen. Justin Allen Kirkpatrick. Joe Rodolfo Kulikowski. Emma Louise Landry. Ting Chen Lee. Nancy Lin. Fengyi Liu. Haojuan Liu. Yuka Liu. Elizabeth Rachel Jane Loganoff. Yiding Ma. Caitlin Mary Marchand. Christopher Blake Barnett Morey. Kylie Ann McCumber. Tegan Elizabeth McGuire. Javier Augusto Morajon Hernandez. James Joseph Murphy. Nathan Andrew Nickerson. Tate Franklin Niemela. Joseph Dominic Novelli. Keegan Leary O'Connor. Gehrig Damon Oppenheimer. Bianca Yvette Ortiz Diaz. Dara O'Sullivan. Natalie Kate Parker. Fei Chin. Jennifer Mary Ricard. Isaac Robert Rosoff. Sean Padreg Savage. Elijah Schleifer. Elizabeth Shu Julzhao Scott. Taylor Marie Shepherd. Michael Thomas Spataro. Cameron Allen Talbert. Shuto Terashima. McLean Reed Timmons. Griffin Sean Tomaszicki. Jeffrey Scott Truax. Michaela Marie Walsh. Xinping Wang. Tsuyoshi Watanabe. Leah Francis White. Connor Joseph Wilkie. Teresa Winkelhoferova. Tess Iona Walterbeek. Harold Melvin Watton. Yukun Wu. Yumin Wu. Shenbang Shu. Hao Zhu. Zijin Zhu. And there they are, the Winchendon School Class of 2020. Before we finish up, we have one last thing to do. Ms. Byrne and our singers will lead the senior song. Seniors and alumni, feel free to sing along at home. Don't be shy. This is your song too, and many of you know the words.
Yeah.
Thank you, students and Ms. Byrne. Winchendon Class of 2020, you are now alumni. Good luck, be remarkable, be resilient, and be courageous in the way you lead your lives. Come back often. We will miss you, but we know that you are starting a whole new chapter, and we are very excited for you. You may now commence. Congratulations.